Let's talk about how MidJourney works and how fun it is. As a developer, the one thing that I'm most uncomfortable with is producing graphical content. But I have good news. AI is progressing in leaps and bounds. It's able to do stuff that just 2 years, or 2 or 3 years ago, I would have said is totally impossible. And now that's being made available to the general public. There's new initiatives from Google and OpenAI and MidJourney that are pushing the boundaries of what art AI can produce. And throughout this video, I'll be showing examples of what I've created on MidJourney with the prompts to allow you to see what is possible. But that raises a few questions. The test to determine whether a computer is self-aware, is able to think, was stated by Turing in 1950. The test is basically, can you tell by chatting with it whether the answers are provided by a human or by a computer? Can we apply the same thing to art? If we show the images to people, can they say, this was drawn by a human and that is created by a computer? Could that be the answer to the question of whether computers can create art? Or should the question be more basic? Does this convey or produce an emotion? And if so, the new techs coming out of Google and OpenAI and MidJourney, are they able to meet either tests? I'll let you be the judge of where you stand, but I know that I've been seriously impressed by what I've seen coming out of MidJourney. I don't really have the answer. What I can talk about is how can we create these images and how does it work technically? Because what's nice is that you can test them out for yourself. OpenAI and MidJourney have both opened up their beta to anyone, although there is a waiting list for OpenAI's dall-e 2. The one I have used, MidJourney, has an original interface. You interact with a Discord bot. And they've recently released a new version of their model, which was trained on, I think, 4 million images. And it's showing even more impressive results than the previous version. I've run a few tests to show you how it works. Basically, once you're on a channel in the Discord, you type /imagine and you start expressing what you want. You can type pretty much anything. You can specify different stars. I've played around with images of a rocket lifting off based on the channel's logo, and I've played at giving it different stars. Here are a few examples. This one, I've specified I wanted an octane render and volumetric lighting. In this one, I've stated that I wanted to be in the style of the French graphic novel artist Enki Bilal and Moebius. I've also done versions in the style of 60s science sci-fi posters and tarot cards and stained glass windows. The range of things that you can do with this is wide, but more than anything else, it's really fun. Of course, there are times when it doesn't understand what you're on about. It seems to be trained on art more than anything else. So for example, just asking it to draw a computer didn't produce much. Now, all that is well and good, but how does it go about this? Well, let me try and explain. You've probably already heard of deep fakes. Those use adversarial neural networks, GANs. One network is trying to fake and the other is attempting to detect the fake. And in a sense, the image generation going on here is doing something similar. What I mean is, because it uses neural networks in a slightly different way than what we're used to. I'll explain. The first step in the process is to teach the model to understand the link between words and images. If we have enough images and they're all correctly labeled, we can teach a neural network to recognize what a banana looks like, or a koala bear, or a motorbike, or a stained glass window, or a drawing by Moebius. That part is fairly easy, or at least we've already been doing it for a while. The next step is to create a process to take our images and to transform them into random noise. So I have a system that can take all these images of bananas and koala bears and motorbikes and transform them into random noise. That's the diffusion process. Now's the fun part. If we reverse the system that creates the noise from the images, we can actually input random noise and produce an image. That's what we call reverse diffusion. And with our labeled data and reverse diffusion, we can teach the model what it means to produce something that looks like a banana or a koala bear or a koala bear on a motorbike. And we can use our first model to check whether it recognizes what is being produced and keep only the most valid versions. Now, I'm curious as to what you think about all this. Is it art? The images that I've shown you are mainly from MidJourney because it's what I have easy access to. But OpenAI's dall-e 2 and Google's Imagine models look like they have a lot of promise. But Google systems are not available to the general public. Why? For two reasons. The first is that because with great power comes great responsibility. The models are producing images that have the potential to be at least as credible as deepfakes, as those produced by the GANs, the adversarial networks, and it's a lot more easy to manipulate. The other problem is that these models contain and encapsulate our society's biases. If the images that the model has seen of CEOs and models are photos of white men in suits, while the model just equates CEO with white and male. And that underlines the difficulty with AI and with computer programs in general. They're only as good as the data that they've been provided with. Garbage in, garbage out. And correcting for those biases first means identifying them. And that is probably the greatest challenge facing AI today.